also getting warmed up too. I want to say things like, I believe that there's work that the Lord wants to do to prepare us to be his people, messengers of compassion. I believe that this is a need for us, starting out with your call. Don't wait. I would tell you a true story. I'll tell it more to you when I come into training college for a spiritual life. I didn't ask God to baptize me with his love until I was out of services as an actual officer in my second year. Too much time was wasted where I hadn't asked God to baptize me with his Holy Spirit. I was under the impression that if everybody would just get their act together and come along with my agenda, then everything would just be fine in my little congregation. And God said, listen, how about instead of me changing them, I change you instead? And I said, baptize me with your love. And he did that. He wants to move to you now at the start of your training. And for others tonight, as we sing tonight, let there be fruit. Just come tonight as the Spirit is speaking to you, as we sing.
Thank you. are sensitive to your Holy Spirit's presence in our midst. And like Isaiah, we recognize the need for cleansing. The need, O God, for you to purify our hearts and make us more like Jesus. So we bow before you, God, broken tonight, and ask, O Heavenly Father, that you would cleanse us and you will fill us afresh with your Holy Spirit, so that the world may believe that you are the true and living God. That the world may believe that there is a King in Zion, and that the Most High rule in the kingdom of men. We thank you that it's the privilege of all believers to be wholly sanctified, and that their whole spirit and soul and body may be preserved blameless unto the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, we claim the baptism of the Holy Spirit tonight. We claim it for our individual lives tonight, O God. Because we know that without the Holy Spirit, we will never make an impact on our world. Lord, without the power of the Holy Spirit in our lives, we will not be changed agents for you. And so, God, do it again for us, Lord. As we gather tonight in what we can describe as an upper room experience, oh God, visit us in your power tonight. Wash us and cleanse us from our sins. And pour your Spirit in our hearts. We pray for your children who are kneeling. We ask, oh God, that you will come, you will descend upon us. That you will cause us, dear God, to bear the marks of Jesus. We look around us today, we realize that we can talk for a long time. We can sing choruses. We can have church. But unless your Holy Spirit is alive in our lives, then we are only sounding brass and tinkling cymbals. So God, we pray as we have never prayed before. And for all of us gathered here tonight, that as we, O God, listen to your word, as we have been challenged by your word, we pray that we will leave this place different people. We will leave this place rejoicing because the Lord has done great things for us. We are glad. We will leave this place as people who are filled with the Spirit of God. As we move into our communities, as we move, oh God, into our homes, people will say, yes, something different, someone is alive in that life. Oh God, do it for us, because we can't do it for ourselves. We claim the blessings tonight. We claim the blessing of a pure heart. We claim the blessing of sanctification. We claim the blessing of full salvation. And we say, it is done. It is done. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you. kind of try to copy the powers to lead us in our final song. And with Earl Morris comes to bring our closing prayer benediction. Let me just say thanks to each of you for coming tonight. For all those who have participated, the band, the cadets, every single person who have done something in this service tonight, we want to say thank you. We want to say thanks for training principle in the Hebrews Exantus. No easy task. For those of us who have been there, we know the challenge. But God has come through for you, Hebrews. And we thank God for you and all that you are doing with your team at the training college. God bless you all, and we wish you a good night as you journey home. Now, let them come and share with Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Our God is good. And all the time, I want you on your feet. What a wonderful night we've had here tonight, yes? What a privilege it is for us, each and every one of us, to be here to witness the welcome to our new session, the Messages of Compassion. What a privilege it is for us to sit under the ministry of God Himself tonight through the words of a territorial commander. And I want to challenge you tonight. Have you got your shield and banner ready? Amen? Have you got your shield and banner ready?
Amen.
That's not good enough. Have you got your shield and banner ready?
Amen.
Amen. So let us march. Let us march with our shield and banner bright. We will work for God and battle for the right. We will praise His name. Amen. Rejoicing in His might. And we'll work till Jesus comes. And the chorus says, then awake. Awake our souls. Awake our bodies. Awake our minds, our hearts. Awake ourselves. Awake. Happy song. Shout for joy. Will you shout for joy?
Amen.
Shout for joy as we gladly march along. We are marching onward, singing as we go. To the promised land where the living waters flow. Come and join our ranks of soldiers here below and work till Jesus comes. You agree with this?
Amen.
Do you believe this?
Amen.
Then let's sing verse 1 and verse 2 straight through. Thank you, Ben. Work till Jesus comes. Let us sing the four first and
heaven, holy is your name, O God. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. We thank you tonight for this time that we spent in your presence. We thank you for our new cadets. We thank you for every soldier, every officer, everyone who has come to be a part of this celebration. We pray your blessing on each of us. We ask, Holy Spirit, that even as we go to our various homes, that you will continue to remind us of the truth of your word, that we will be the doers of your word and not just hearers. We ask in Jesus' name. And now for our final blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace. Amen.
Amen.
God go with you.
Amen.